So, I am working on another long shot Centurion pump crit. The last one used a Gavin Fuzzy V1. This time we went with a Worker Low Pro, which is what I wish I'd done the first time. Because this rail right here, which is part of the kit, makes the pumping so much easier. So this is actually for my buddy Randy. Him and I are doing a blaster swap. He's doing a strife for me, and I'm doing one of these for him. So he sent along some internals and everything. I'm doing an integration and a custom paint job. So right now I am using a mouse sander, which is terrific for doing shell because it's very, very gradual. It's very much like a mix between hand sanding. I know a lot of people who use Dremels and they're great. And I'll use Dremels a lot for like removing safety warnings or Nerf logos or whatever. But this mouse sander is even better, especially for removing textures. Like the long shot has this kind of weird particle-y texture, and the Centurion has that Digicam stuff. So this mouse sander is actually doing a terrific job removing that Nerf logo, like without really leaving any scarring on the shell. So I'm gonna be putting on some music and I'm gonna be sanding for just a little bit before I get to work checking some epoxy that's drying. So other than that, mask, because anytime you're doing any electrically assisted sanding or any sanding really, it's good to have one of these, especially if you're sanding anything that's already been epoxied or puttied, because that stuff is not great to breathe. But really none of this is great to breathe, so hence the mask. And there goes the long shot label. Now this is what I'm talking about, how a mouse sander, I don't know why I'm yelling over my own music. So this is why the mouse sander works so great for this application, is that is a really nice, even sand. Now I used to use a Dremel for removing these, which if you're really careful is a great way to do it. Don't get me wrong, otherwise you'll be hand sanding forever. But like for real, this mouse sander applies a nice even pressure. I got this one for like less than $30 at Home Depot, but it is great for removing all those textured surfaces, because with the Centurion label and the warning labels and that
Digicam, you know, if I'm going to do a paint job, I need to make sure that it matches underneath. So that's why I'm sanding this whole body down and getting rid of all the textures. And then I can apply texture again later when I'm painting.
If I can get my phone to stand up, that'd be a good start. So yeah, the mouse has a whole bunch of different attachments. This one, oh wait, you went to BG Undead? Like if my wife weren't like literally about to pop out this baby, like literally, she could call me right now and be like, hey, we're in labor and it's time to go. So I was so hoping to go to BG, and looking at the pictures made me insanely jealous. So it looked great. But yeah, anyway, this mouse sander, highly recommend it, especially that it has like the shovel tip, means you can kind of get into corners. So some paint, sanding down something like as big as a long shot, instead of taking me hours of hand sanding, I'll be able to knock out most of this in about half an hour if I quit stopping to talk. And then hand sand after that. So I should probably stop talking. Anyway, this is... I'm not gonna name this song. If you know it, great. If not, I'm not repeating the name. It's not exactly appropriate. Beautiful song, but neither the band nor the album are very appropriate. But the song is called Blue Monday. There you go. How about that?
technically the due date is August 22nd, but she's 39 weeks, so 5 minutes from now, next week, I don't know. I'm trying to think of a better way to hold this. Oh, my phone has gone through so much worse than this. All right. See if I can cheat.
The problem is, it's sitting on my workstation, and my workstation is vibrating because I'm sanding. Not too well thought out. There's gotta be a better way. Good looking out, Pete. I'll have to grab one. Goodbye to Centurion. So, now we've removed that annoying Centurion and a lot of the Digicam. I'm gonna leave this texture on the back because it's just really annoying to get through all that. And then I'm gonna balance out the inside of this with some hand sanding. But other than that, the rest of this part's gonna be all hand sanding just to get that nice even grit. So I might swap out to just like a really fine grit on the mouse sander and finish this joker off. the person I'm building this, the person I'm building this for does want it in the Stormtrooper paint. Though I'm doing a little bit different because a lot of his stuff has got this really cool like Jedi theme to it. So it's going to be mostly black and white, but I'm going to throw in some blue in there, and I'm actually going to make it like a clone trooper style, so with like a CT number and Republic decals instead of Imperial, and make it more of like a clone trooper themed one to tie into his Jedi blasters. It just seemed to make a little bit more sense than going like Stormtrooper versus Jedi. Yeah, I've already done one of these before. It's hanging up on the wall. You can check out my other video, T28, to see what it looks like. And there's also pictures of it on my Facebook at TK1138Nerf. But yes, this one's for Randy, and it's going to be a little bit different, utilizing a lot of the lessons I learned doing the first ones, which, let me tell you guys, was a lot of lessons. So, yeah, this is going way better than the last time. I hope to do a lot more of these like workshop vlogs. I've got a whole bunch of crazy projects I'm working on during the baby duty saga, duty with T-O's. A whole bunch of projects I've been meaning to get done, but I am recovering. I'm actually still in a fair amount of pain. This YouTube video, guys, is brought to you by water. Why is water important? You should drink lots and lots of it and not drink as much beer. Otherwise, you'll develop the fun thing known as kidney stones, which is what knocked me on my butt Friday. That was truly terrible, and one of the most agonizing experiences of my life was having kidney stones. I've got two out, two to go, so drinking lots of water and praying that my medication works very well. Also, if you drink a lot of soda, don't do that either. But yeah, oh, hang on. I'll show you guys, this is how I take it easy. Thank you. Let me show you the other project I'm working on. I'm working on my Mandalorian Stalker armor. So it's got the base coat, it's gonna be white and gray with black and blue accents. And yeah, I'm pretty stoked about this. So, I've got a lot of projects I'm gonna be working on. This, a couple other ones. I was gonna do a reflective chrome, but I'm gonna do black instead because it's gonna be mostly white. I kinda need that black to tie it in. But yeah, got some plans for like a Roto Fury that I'm gonna be doing, and this, and a Gen Urso, and a Demolisher, and just all sorts of stuff. I'm also going to be working on a blaster for the 1138 subscriber giveaway, because that's what I'm doing this time. So, I'm doing a special Stormtrooper-themed blaster for a giveaway at 1138 subscribers. Because that's my number! I just realized you guys can't see me smiling, so that was kind of foolish. This is why I love this thing. In fact, I bought it because I told my wife I'm using it to finish furniture. Which is partially true. I did finish some furniture. I sanded down this changing station and I spray painted it white. The same white I use on my blasters. And when my wife wasn't looking, I managed to sneak some Imperial Star Wars stickers on my daughter's changing station. It's pretty great. A little bit of good. You can. She knows. She's already seen it. She saw the Imperial insignia. She goes, fine, whatever. So, now I've got a Star Wars Imperial Stormtrooper changing table. And I'm getting the vinyl goods, the guy who does the vinyl work for me, and who's gonna be doing the vinyl work on this blaster. Let's see if I can get some more decals from him. I am currently sanding a long shot Centurion integration with a low profile tactical rail and a worker low profile pump grip for my friend Randy, who I'm doing a blaster trade with. He is working on a full on, like, with 3D printed kits and everything, Strife. That I cannot wait to get so I can feature on here. And then there's some other exciting stuff coming out of the SCNC that some products that I've mentioned on my Facebook page, TK1138 Nerf, that I'm really gonna be looking forward to getting my hands on that. Like, I'm just gonna go ahead and mail my credit card to Project FDL. He might as well hang on to it, because I'm gonna need some stuff. But just look how smooth that sander took that off. I mean, like, perfect. God, I love this thing. So yeah, those of you with girlfriends or wives, say you want to finish furniture. And those of you living with your parents, tell them the same thing. Be like, I think I would like to work on furniture. Parents dig that sort of thing. Just saying. Later, Daniel. As for the internals, why? Hey, a Lego designer would be pretty cool. But the guy who wants it sent along an alpha kit and some other internal pieces that are all gonna go into this. So, here we go. Alpha kits cannot. However, the Omni kit, that was an expansion to the Alpha kit, will allow for firing of full-range darts, or full-size darts. So then all it is a matter of swapping out one part for one or the other. Yeah, I got eaten in End War, but it was good. It was a good tag. That guy got me dead to rights. I remember the mouth of the cave. That place was crazy. A lot of people died. It was actually even like a month after End War when I finally did the footage of Mission 3 Part 1. And when Ari, the moderator, sent me his voiceover stuff. And he says, unlike most moderator special zombies, my instructions were to kill as many humans as possible. That gave me chills. Even a month after End War. And he was terrific. Like, as a special, that bunny was something else, man. Yeah, dude, this thing is amazing. Piggy, I would definitely recommend either a long shot or a retaliator for springers that are the best. Like if you're talking like a mag-fed one. But yeah, a fire strike or a night finder for pistols are definitely terrific. I've seen a couple, I don't even remember all the names. Honestly, you'd be better off like looking at Chris Cartea's earlier stuff. He does a lot of like brass pistols and whatnot. Bradley Phillips, I believe, did some, or Tiger Foam. Tiger Foam did some. He does some good brass breaching, too, from what I've seen. I hope to go to Australia and nerf with them one day. That'd be terrific. I really don't even need that anymore. I don't know why I'm still using it. Is this a cam show? Well, it really depends on what you mean by a cam show. This is about as undressed as I'm gonna get. So if that's what you're here for. That being said, I will be stripping the varnish and the clear coat off this blaster. Pause for a dramatic effect. So, I've done with the mouse sander for right now. I've sanded off all I'm really gonna need to with that. Yes, this is another one, the same as the last, but smarter and with some better pieces. Yes, it did get a little awkward. Anyway, I am now switching to some 400 grit sandpaper for really finishing off that sanding. Now, I know a lot of people who are like, oh yeah, I do like, you know, 200 and then 400, then 800, then 1,000 grit. That's great. I got a lot to work on, guys. I'm not using 1,000 grit sandpaper on a Nerf project that I'm about to paint. That's a little bit weird. I don't know about weird, but it's excessive. Now, for those people who are doing like a candy job paint, like one of those like candy apple reds or some of those, maybe that's like a really good thing to do for those kind of things. But, Whoop. Knocked out my phone charger. I think I got it. Let's see. Well, we'll find out if my phone dies in like 10 minutes. Which is probably for the best, because it'll probably be time to eat by then. Who knows? Yeah, exactly, Nick. There's, like, very little reason. Like, I've, on all my blasters, and I do some pretty intense paint jobs, I still don't use more than, like, a 440 grit. And, I mean, maybe I'm a noob, but my paint jobs have come out fairly nice, so I'm not overly concerned that I'm doing something wrong. That's not to say that there's not room for improvement. Like I said, up until recently, I've been hand sanding everything, like from the beginning. Good to know. I really don't work much around asbestos, so my likelihood of contracting mesothelioma isn't too great, but I appreciate you looking out, Casey. Thanks, Slick With It. You know what I'm working on. Yes, Nerf modding 547. Nice. If you got any pictures of it and you're active on Facebook, I'd love to see that. You can post it in a comment on my Facebook page at TK1138Nerf. I really love seeing all like the Stormtrooper blasters out there, because there's some, you guys have done some really terrific projects. Randy's done some really cool ones. My friend Walter Sharpless, who now has his own YouTube channel and Facebook page, Walt Sharp, who does a lot of like great deals on Nerf parts. I definitely recommend checking him out. He does black and white, so it's pretty cool stuff. When you first mod a long shot, what would you recommend doing from Chillzilla? Honestly, I would remove a lot of the extra stuff inside the plunger tube, and you can even make like a quick angel breech or like a quick kind of brass breech, and it adds a lot. But really, streamlining the airflow through the plunger is a great way to go. I probably could, but yeah.
Yeah, it's growing. Got my SCNC flag, a stroller, because, you know, baby. Got the whole workbench, all the blasters, additional storage, more blasters and work tables. All my gear's in there. That's kind of cool. There's a map from End War 2017 that I've highlighted, like where the missions were, stuff like where I died. That's on that map. That's good to have. Still haven't quite finished installing this spray booth so I can spray paint inside. I'm honestly thinking about giving it up. You know, it's like, it's a lot of work. I'm not even sure about the status of the motor. And I could put a lot of storage in there. But at the same time, how many people have a spray paint booth in their basement? I feel like that would earn me like serious nerd points. So I might have to. I might just do it for the nerd points, guys.
YSU what? What? I've never been to Youngstown State, you know? YSU? I'm guessing that's what you meant. Yeah, long shots, especially if you're using an older one, like if they've been dry fired too much, they are susceptible to breaking. I've got an entire bucket of long shot internals over there from how many I've thrifted that were just garbage or just cracked. It's a lot. I think I'm gonna sit down now. This one is for my friend Randy, who you remember, Randy. He let you borrow his FDL for the final mission at NWAR. Him and I are doing a blaster swap. I'm making him a long shot that's functionally identical to my T28, including the external body pieces with a little bit of difference in the kit. And I am doing it in the same colors generally as mine. A little bit of tweaking specifically in custom for Randy. I'm really excited about doing that. As well as the custom decals, which are also going to be a bit different. Standing forever, guys. I am down south. I am actually outside of Birmingham, Alabama. Yeah. It was a long drive to NWAR. But it was a good drive because I got to go with my boys. Tac Squad, Flying Chicken, and Jackie of Project FDL and the founder of Sparkle Squad, who had that really awesome light-up FDL for Mission 3. Sadly, she died with me on Mission 3.
Snack Squad!
Snack Squad was awesome, man. Yeah, it wasn't a terrible drive. It definitely wasn't the worst drive I've made. And again, I did it with friends, and we took turns driving, so, like, I'm gonna scoot out a little bit so this doesn't look nearly so weird. Just saying. Awesome, Blaster Foam. What you working on? Nice. I feel really bad. Slick with it, who commented just a little earlier, him and I and his awesome son were, they were over here doing a mod day with me, and we were working on doing a strife, and we managed to modify or change out some of the mods on one of his, and then my soldering iron died. It was actually kind of embarrassing. Play with the HANU. What's the HANU? Why did my voice crack when I asked that? I don't know. So I've actually done a couple of these live modding videos about this specific project on my YouTube. I mean, not my YouTube. This is my YouTube. On my Facebook, which was really cool. And you know, I originally did it so I could keep it. The problem is, this music that I'm listening to while I work is copyrighted material, which Facebook will not allow you to keep a live video if it has copyrighted music in it. Go figure. So I was like, you know what? I really was slacking. Yay! Yeah, so I was in the emergency room on a Friday for kidney stones. Hooray. Part of growing old. Though don't think just because you're young, you're okay. Because, hey, I'm kind of young. Should I go? Oh, no, it's gone. It's gone for, there it is, to an HVZ with older people. Well, you gotta go to an HVZ eventually. I started doing HVZ when I was in college, but, you know, that's when it was starting up. September, yes. Yeah, far from a strike. So yeah. Pretty excited. But other than that, yeah, Randy, it'd be awesome to have you down. Again, I do live like 2 hours away from Project FDL. So, you know, it's a little bit of a drive out here. Plus, Project FDL shop is... I mean, it's cool. I mean, it's full of FDLs, so... In my mind, it's already inherently cooler than my shop, but, like, style-wise, no way, man. This shop beats FDL's shop for style, but, again, this shop doesn't make FDLs, so... I don't know. Thanks, dude! Glad you watched, man. Like... We just passed 1,000 subscribers, guys. So I've actually got to start working on a blaster here because I want to give away a custom blaster for the 1138 subscriber giveaway. I don't know. But at the same time, I feel like a piece of gear would probably be better, like, and more suited to my channel than, like, a blaster. Because truth be told, you know, I do decent blasters. But, you know... There's some really terrific modders out there, guys. So it's a little intimidating for me, but tactical gear, I know that. And yeah, Randy, that FDL 2V, I'm already working on it. What is the best dart for semi-modified long shot with a recon spring, air restrictor moved, and locks removed? Well, it depends on where you play. Honestly, I've seen mixed... Well, if you're not brassing it... I don't know. Wow, I about said Whistlers. Like, it's 2009. Waffle darts are pretty terrific. But I've also seen... Koosh works really well. Oh, no, you're not flywheels. I don't know. It depends on the rules of your club. I'm not a fan of FDJs in a lot of ways. But they are pretty terrific for, like, modified long shots. But that being said, it depends on your spring load because they are traditionally heavier. What is the definition of NIC? Nerf Internet Community. This is the NIC. I'm the NIC. You're the NIC. But in terms of like war, NIC typically means like homemade blasters and modified darts. Whereas in a lot of clubs, including like the SCNC, you'll have Super Stock, which is modified blasters, but stock darts. Stock darts typically weigh 1.1 to like 1.22 grams. So that has a very specific like critical velocity, which is how fast it'll travel. Busby Precision Darts, I've heard a lot about them. Other than like from thrifting, I mean, actually this was thrifting. I finally got my first Busby blaster, other than like a Wizard. And I picked up a Sentinel at the thrift store for 99 cents. I kind of see I see why people like that blaster. It's a fun little blaster, guys. Oh, this is gonna be baby smooth. Baby smooth. So yeah, I hope to do more of these live vlogs. I still have N-War footage. I have Mission 5 as a zombie. And then of course the final stand where I took out a lot of people, including the Flying Chicken from the SCNC and Ryan Giles from Make Test Battle were among my victims. And then Mission 5, some terrific, terrific fun there. That was definitely not a good mission for the humans. For those of you at N-War who did go to Mission 5, you know what I'm talking about. It was not a good war for the humans. That's an understatement. But, yeah, and that one's, those will have drone footage, but you know, I'm giving it a break, and I'm doing some other content, you know, I'm doing these, especially as the day my wife has a baby is ever approaching. In fact, it could be today. I don't even know. Well, Piggy, I do remember you earlier saying you were 10 years old. There are specific rules for HVZ N-War, which should... That hasn't been announced yet, but I imagine it's going to be in Athens, Ohio again this year. And it does have a minimum age to play of 12, but you have to have your parent, like, with you. Not, like, drop you off or sign you off. Like, they have to be running with you. And then I believe it's, like, 15 or 16 to run by yourself. I don't know. There's a couple of... I don't know. There's some better people to ask, for sure, about that one. Yeah, Mission 5 was nuts, guys. And you'll see a lot of it in the video when I get to it. I hope that I'm saving that for my baby duty, which is after my daughter's born. You know, I'm opening up the vault. I've got a lot of gameplay stored up, including some really good SCNC ones. My friend Scott Tomlin firing an FDL blaster at me. By the way, Scott, if you're still here, I saw your FDL. Jesse sent me a picture, and it's gorgeous. So I'm glad that, you know, we've kind of come full circle. Well, it depends, Parker, like, what you consider the best. Gavin Fuzzy, especially his V2, is a terrific kit. I've got the V1 on my long shot. The V2 is really comfortable. At first, I was hesitant about the worker because it looks very angular. But, like, I have the worker low-profile pump grip that I'm doing on this, and it's great. And it's got a Picatinny attachment, so you can put, like, whatever... like angled foregrip you want, so that's great. And it comes with this piece like right here along the bottom that makes it a really easy prime. Awesome Nerf Modding 547. I'm definitely gonna be stoked to check it out when I'm not all covered in this stuff. Replacement flywheels. Well, it honestly depends on the cage you're running. Now, the nice thing is you can get the Worker Delrin Flyass wheels, and they will fit in a stock Strife cage. And they will, they're high, you know, they're really great wheels. I used to run them in a stock cage briefly, and they definitely added an improvement. That being said, they are like tight fit wheels, so they are tricky to get on and even harder to get off. So you gotta be careful with those. There's some explanations on how the best way to remove them is, but yeah, I definitely like the fly ass wheels. Well, Piggy, you're gonna have trouble with finding an HVZ that you're gonna be able to play by yourself at your age, unfortunately. A lot of HVZs are actually like specifically around colleges. Now, there are invitationals that they do open to like a lot of ages. But you will find that anyone that's like a big HVZ is gonna have insurance reasons to have you like have a guardian with you. I mean, it all depends if you have older siblings that can come along or something. I'm not entirely sure, so please don't quote me on that. But, you know, unfortunately, there's the best thing you can do at this age is find, like, a good local Nerf club, if there's any, and participate with them. I know there's a whole bunch in the Ohio area, and, yeah, there's a lot of great Nerf clubs. Be standing forever, guys. Pinky out. Alright, what is your favorite Nerf blaster? Well, that depends. Nerf brand? Because that kind of affects things. In terms of style points, I really love the Barrel Break. That was one of my favorites. But I have to say, like, one of my favorites, like, in terms of, like, nostalgia would be the Barricade. That was, like, my go-to blaster during HVZ in college was a Barricade and a Mag Strike with a recon pistol. So, I'm a little nostalgic. As for, like, current blasters, the Elite Alpha Trooper is definitely on the list. Yo, I'm gonna guess you're Salem Engel. I don't know. I just can't imagine there's that many people that have that little icon. And if you are, then I do want to apologize for denying you into the SCNC 11 times. That was me. To be fair, I was trying to message you to explain why, but I couldn't message you. I don't know. So yeah, no hard feelings. Yes, you did. You requested 11 times. But you didn't have any profile pictures or any information, so yeah. Awesome, dude. I mean, I still consider myself a beginning modder. I'm an experienced nerfer. I've been nerfing for a while, but, like, modding is something I'm still learning as I'm going along. So, thanks for watching. I'm still figuring it out as I go, too. You know, I've got a little bit going for me in that, like, you know, I'm an engineer, so I do get to learn all sorts of cool stuff doing that sort of stuff. But, yeah, other than that, you know, I'm no Drac or Carius. Carius is a mad scientist. An underrated mad scientist. Like, for real. That guy's nuts. Yeah, the FDL2 was, it was a hard pill to swallow, price-wise. It really was. But I don't regret it. You know, I saved some aside, and I bought less stuff, I thrifted more, and then I just started saving all the money I made from thrifting stuff and selling it. I used that to buy, you know, my FDL2, and I definitely don't regret it, you know. But anyway, for those of you joining, I am working on a Longshot Centurion integration with a low-profile tactical rail. Where do you get your mags? I, for a while, ran the Worker 22s, which are really great mags. They've got their drawbacks. I'll talk about that in a post eventually, because apparently I'm the only one that had a problem with them, but I bought a dozen of them. I still have them. I don't use them anymore. But yeah, so they're great. Other than that, thrifting or sales, that's about it. I use 18s, and I've custom painted them. I want to mod a Rapid Strike. What would suggest for battery? Well, if you're up for it, a LiPo, and a 3S at that. Do you know how to fix a broken air restrictor on a Crossfire? I got it at a yard sale. Not familiar with the internals for a Crossfire, depending on how broken it's the air restrictor is or what's broken, maybe. I don't know. Nice! Yeah, I talk with Jesse every day, like we're part of a group chat. And I go over to his house to work on it and to work on FDLs with him, so that's kind of cool. Amazon is good, especially if, all right, 12 round mags. I have played with some of the knockoff 12-round and 18-round magazines available on Amazon, and I really like them. In fact, especially like the Yamix 12s, those are really nice. Yamix is the guys, those are the ones that make the AccuFakes that I reviewed earlier. They are terrific. I mean, like, aesthetically, I love 12-round mags. The size is great. An 18 just kind of looks silly, but at the same time, it's just, especially with, like, an FDL2, I do like the mount of darts in a drum. Unfortunately, the FDL2 on full auto doesn't handle drums very well. The springs, the follower springs in a magazine usually can't keep up with 13 darts a second. Really, you know, the Demolisher is a weird blaster. I've seen a lot of magazines that just don't. I bought a Demolisher off a Facebook buy-sell trade group, and it had like mags and an Alpha Trooper and all sorts of really cool stuff in there that I was excited about. And on one of the 18 mags was, do not ever put in a Demolisher, and I was really curious. You need two 22 clips taped together. No. All right. I'm dirty, but I'm going to show you something. And if you think the 18s look ridiculous, hang on. All right. So, these are all my Worker 22s. I've got an even dozen of them. This is an FDL2. It's a 15-round mag. Look how ridiculous that 22-round mag looks in here. Like, for real. Like, there is an End War 2 already in planning. Probably going to be in Athens, Ohio. But yes, there is an End War 2. Stay tuned and follow like the End War page. They'll be announcing it. But yes, look at that. Especially without the stock. Do you see how oversized a Worker 22 is? Yeah, I used to have about 80 magazines. I've just been slowly giving them away. In fact, Pete Fuzzy Pete got some of my magazines. FDL got a bunch because I outfitted him with a ton before End War. Yeah, for a Raider, I would definitely put a Rampage in it, honestly. The P-Mags are sick. Aesthetically, if we're talking about my favorite magazine, it would definitely be the Worker 15. Like, beautiful, especially the new hexagon ones, also really pretty. The Worker 15 is my favorite looking mag, hands down. That being said, curved mags are a little tricky to do in a loadout. I did have the Worker 22s, but they have a little rubber thing on the bottom, which I probably could have just shown you. They don't fit well in my mag holders. And 22s, like, because they have that little ring on the bottom, you can't, like, put them in top-loaded, like, 3D-printed ones or fabric ones. I had to turn them upside down. They're okay. They're just really long. Hang on. They're just a little oversized and not very stable. That was a lot better way to say what I was about to say. I'm not really sure what I'm doing with the Worker 22s. I haven't used them in, like, 6 months. I got a dozen of them sitting in a box. I bought them for, like, $9 a piece from, like, Taobao. And then just had them sent over on a boat. You can actually look at some of my old pictures and you'll see them in there. The 22s jam. Yes. I had a lot of problems with the follower not following on my Worker 22s. A lot of people don't have any idea what I'm talking about. And they're like, no, they work great. Literally, the only way my Worker 22s worked with my FDL2 was if I was using 18 rounds and not 22. Otherwise, they just wouldn't work. What are your thoughts on narrow-based 3D-printed products? I've never used them. I have some Dart Dragon 3D-printed, and Project FDL is experimenting with making some really cool mag holders that I want to play with. He rocked those at NWAR. They have little clips on them to hold really cool stuff. I like 3D printed ones. If you can find some, if you can find a file online, which there are free files available to find, and you have access to a 3D printer, you can usually make them. The one complaint I've had and the reason I don't have narrowbase, guys, I've put like $500 or $600 in my gear over the years. But I still won't pay for narrowbase. Right now I've only been running 18 Nerf mags because they are the most reliable for jams, which is my priority, no jams. Absolutely. That's why at HVZ End War I ran 18 round magazines. They're tried, they're true, they're dependable. I oiled them and I cleaned them, and then I actually painted all of mine custom so that way like I could take them to End War, and if I lost one, I might be able to recover it. But that's the other reason I didn't bring the 22s, is because I actually lost 3 magazines at End War. Because there were times where I would rather throw a magazine down while running and reload and not die than try to hold on to a mag and die because of it. But that was why I used 18s, because they're so replaceable. But yeah, they're custom painted with custom decals and everything. They looked really cool, and I was super psyched to use them at End War. And I'm happy that I still got a bunch left. So they are definitely my go-to magazines now. I'm definitely an 18-round stick kind of guy. They definitely, I say definitely a lot, but they are great in, like, Molly pouches and all sorts of stuff. I mean, ergonomically, 12s are better. I'm going to go ahead and say it. Especially doing, like, reload drills, 12-round magazines are the best way to go. But, at the same time, you're talking, like, 4 rounds of ammo difference. The Force Awakens Stormtrooper Blaster. I do! Somewhere. I've got one in a box. It used to be on my wall. It's not anymore. England is my city. Well, that's terrific. England's a nation, but that's okay. I want a Rapid Strike as a primary, Modded Strife as a secondary, and a heavily modded Hammer Shot as a pistol. Thoughts? So, for several months, I ran a modified Rapid Strike. It was terrific. I love that blaster. The range and accuracy was terrific. I enjoyed it, but it ate a lot of ammo. Okay, well, Brent, I still recommend an FDL2 as well, but, like, an FDL2 is also, like, $360 to $390, depending on the filaments you use. Not completely practical. I ran a Rapid Strike, and I loved it. A modified Rapid Strike is definitely a force to be reckoned with, and I just don't use mine anymore, but it's a lot of fun. I modified mine, like, to the nines. And then I run a Strife as a sidearm. It's a tier one Strife, you know, with high crush flywheel cage and flywheels and a 3S LiPo and 3S motors, and I enjoy it. It's great because it uses the same magazines. My old Springer loadout used a Hammer Shot. It's always, yeah, well, honestly, it's not about the blaster, dude. Like, my boy Chicken, the Flying Chicken, a very famous name, ran with a slightly modified Alpha Trooper for the entire End War. And you know what? With all my gear and all my blasters, he outlived me. He made it to the final stand with nothing but an Alpha Trooper, which I have a sinking suspicion might have been stock. Don't quote me on that. I think it might have had a 5 kilogram, but that's it. So, yeah, Chicken was wrecking with that Alpha Trooper, guys. But anyway, back to loadout. A Hammer Shot, I use an Apex Tactical holster. And when I do my Springer loadout, I use a Hammer Shot, like, at End War for Mission Zero, which was a nighttime mission, and it was pouring buckets. I left all my flywheels, but I packed Springers in case of rain. And I ran my modified Alpha Trooper and my Hammer Shot for Mission Zero, and it was great. But, yeah, Strifes are so versatile. You can make a great primary with them, or I use mine as a sidearm, so. Let's see. Chicken murdered with the thing. You'll actually, when I post my video of the final stand, I was the one that killed Flying Chicken. Because I've nerfed with him for so long that I know how he fires, and I had a shield. So, yeah, I got him. and it was really touching because it was a hug and it was a nice moment. I do like the Rival line. I got an Apollo. I thrifted it. I actually have never bought a new Blast. Wait, that's not true. My Kmart went out of business, so I have a new Artemis in box. I'm gonna give away at an SCNC war at some point, or raffle it, or something. I don't know. I just bought it because it was like $20, and it usually goes for $44, so I scooped one up. But yeah, I like the Rival line. I just haven't really had much experience with it. You know, I don't know. Like, statistically, I've played with a lot of people who use Rival. I know they're good blasters. I really can't even give a concrete reason why I don't use it. Maybe I just feel like I've got so much invested in mags and darts and all that. Who knows, man? I don't. If I were to get one, it'd probably be the Hera. Ah, that's a good question, dude. And the reality is because at the end of the day, Nerf is a product for children or for people to use in their homes. So if you make a sniper rifle, that's great. If it can hit someone at, you know, 100 yards and not hurt, great. But what happens if a 5-year-old shoots another 5-year-old at point blank with it? And that's why Nerf doesn't make them. Have you heard of the Boba Fett Apollo? Yes. I just don't want to spend that kind of money for it, especially because I could do a paint job. If you had to choose one primary besides the FTL2, what would it be? It would be a Strife. It really would. You know, they're lightweight. They're easy to modify. You can do so much with a Strife. And then, you know, put it on a sling. I mean, really, guys. A Strife will shoot as fast as you can pull the trigger. So, yeah, I know it's the cliche everyone says Strife, but truthfully, if I had to pick one primary that wasn't an FDL2, it would definitely be a Strife. What about your Rapid Strike? I love my Rapid Strike. The problem is, it takes a lot of work to not burn through darts like crazy. You know, and that's the thing. It shoots 11 darts per second. If you hold the trigger for at all, like, it's gone. Like, pfft, whole mag, gone. And so, it's not practical for long wars like End War. Like, yeah, I lack self-control too. In fact, if you go back and watch, like, my videos from, like, SCNC 29 and earlier, you can see me using a Rapid Strike. Show us your hat. It's literally just a black hat. That's it. My hair is a mess, so that's why I'm wearing a hat. Have you played with any Boomco blasters? I've got a Far Shot. I just joke around with it in the shop. I bought one for funsies, because I could. It was like $1, and I was like, I've never had one, so I got one. But, yeah, again, Strife. I don't know. You know who uses my Rapid Strike the most lately? Has been Dart Dragon. He's actually used it lately in a couple of missions when his blaster had some trouble. I don't have a soldering iron anymore. It died last weekend. I had a mod party going on in my shop. Had a couple of guys from Birmingham, some really cool dudes, Raymond and Ryan, really close friends of mine. And we just finished putting together one of his Strifes. Was about to start wiring in the artifact cage on the second one. My soldering iron wouldn't get hot, so I have to buy a new one. If I use a Strife as a primary, what should my secondary be? Gotta go. Later, Jason. It's been good seeing you again, man. Or talking with you. Don't be a stranger, man. And yeah, we'll definitely talk about some loadout stuff. See, here's the deal, Steven. I'm a weird guy about my loadouts. In that, cross-compatibility is key. I saw a couple of guys running around at NWAR who had, like, a Rival blaster with mags, like, Nerf mags across their chest and a Boomco pistol. That might be great. They might be all terrific blasters, but they don't share an ammo type. So if one of them runs out, that's it. You just got to carry it with you or chuck it in a bush. I like sharing compatible ammos. So, like, if I were having a Strife as a primary and my option to have a secondary wasn't another Strife, a hammer shot's not bad as a front loader, but I'd probably use a modified retaliator as a sidearm. But that's probably biased because back in my old HVZ days, I always used a recon. We wouldn't have known about Project FDL without those. Sweet. I'm really glad, man. Like, I'm glad you guys watch it. FDL's a really cool dude who makes a terrific product, and I'm just glad to get him some more, like, light so people can see how awesome his work is. So, have you ever played sports? I was a competitive swimmer for, like, 11 years. Yeah. I played soccer when I was 8, was terrible at it, which is a shame, because as a German, you're expected to be good at soccer. No, I'm a swimmer. Bro, do you mind if I add you on Facebook? Absolutely. Totally. You can check out, I have a Nerf Facebook page, at TK1138Nerf, and definitely check me out there. I post updates, you can shoot me messages, if you got questions, I answer those messages pretty quick, so definitely recommend finding me on, at TK1138Nerf. A lot of you might have even seen my personal Facebook, which is no problem, because I post in, like, Nerf Modders Welcome, or Nerfaholics Anonymous. It's about Evan B. Nerf from time to time. But, yeah, open book, guys. You guys can totally add me if you got questions or want to shoot a message. Sorry, I'm doing a lot of sanding right now. I think I missed a question. Well, three guns, Steven, is not a bad idea. Like, I'd really considered keeping a hammer shot stuck on my, my backpack as an absolutely last measure at Enwar. So that, like, if for whatever reason something happened and it rained or... You know, having a front loader is always a solid plan. Is there a story behind your flag? I've got an SCNC flag there. I got another SCNC flag behind that flag. And that one my wife got me for Father's Day because she knows I love the Empire and got me that flag, which originally I was going to hang in front of my house, but I loved it so much I just kept it in my workshop. It was really cheap on Amazon. It was like $20. I was like, that's terrific. So I'm going to go buy a flagpole and I'm going to go hang it in my front yard. Because I'm a nerd. So, other than that, you can usually catch me in the SCNC page. I'm an admin in the SCNC. Oh god, my phone almost died. You guys see that? You might have. Do you have a favorite mod you have ever done? I don't know. Social Nerf, this is my one beer. First beer. I get two beers a night right now. And they're not allowed to be within an hour of each other. The reason is, my wife is 39 weeks pregnant and can go into labor at any minute. Literally, any minute, guys. So, I don't even get a buzz. I drink one beer and the next one will be probably sometime after dinner. Because, again, I have to be able to drive at any moment's notice. Anyway, back to the favorite mod. I don't know. I really enjoyed doing my Demolisher. I never finished it. It's up there. It's got a Jace 3D battery tray and rhinos. I just haven't finished it yet. It's pretty close, though. But that's because in the SCNC, we do a game type called Defend the Core, where rockets count for 20 points. If you guys want to know that one, that's one of my favorite videos I've done on YouTube. You can find it at SCNC Austin's Birthday under my gameplay videos, Defend the Core, in which our team makes 180 points and 60 of them are mine doing rockets. Do you know how to take the barrel off a Centurion? Yes. After you've clicked a Centurion barrel to the body, after it's come out of the box, you literally have to disassemble it to take it back apart. I am really concerned about money. I have a small paying job. What are your suggestions? Well, it depends. If you're talking about like a good solid blaster that it's literally, you're not going to have to throw much into it for it to be a good time, I recommend an Alpha Trooper and an Orange Mod Work Stage 1. That's it. Don't go to the Stage 2. I have the Stage 1. I have the Stage 2. And honestly, the amount of gain you get from the Stage 2 just isn't worth it. But it's a very practical, very robust blaster, and as long as you don't dry fire it, it'll treat you right. I still have mine. Other than that, a Strife. The only downside to getting into modded flywheels is that there's a high initial cost of entry if you want to do it the right way. Because now I can mod a Strife for like $60 and have a really good one. But that means it's because I've already got the battery charger and I've already got a battery. The battery charger for a good one's already $25. Plus, you're talking like $15 for a good lipo, and then you're looking at, that's $40 right there. So, plus a fireproof bag for lipo, which I highly recommend for anybody if you don't have like a metal. Yeah, stripes are great because literally, once you've got you can buy the motors, wire those ones in. You can go to get a lipo, then you can put in like some wheels and then a cage. I mean, it's one you can do slowly. And that's a big plus when you don't have a whole bunch of liquid funds available at one time. Oh my God. This is taking me forever. The Strife did not get discontinued. It didn't. They are still available in the States. You just gotta find them. Also, they are still available in Canada and other places. They have brand new packaging done in metric. Do you have to take a priming handle off a Centurion to take it apart? You do, using a flathead screwdriver. Hang on one sec. I have a feeling that was my wife. Oh no, it wasn't. Okay. She's probably just gonna stomp, like, my kitchen's right above me. I'm surprised she hasn't, like, started stomping and going, "It's dinner time!" Alright, that was my one beer. Sad day. I miss a question. It's not a stupid question, Sandstorm. It really isn't. Lipos are not dangerous. They're not. But it's like one of those things, you've got to take care of it the right way. It's like a knife. I carry a pocket knife because it's useful to have. And as long as you're smart, a lipo's fine. You know, there's a lot of horror stories about lipos. You know, if you leave them out in the sun or they get too hot, they expand. You know, if you over-discharge them, you know. I don't recommend it for everybody, you know, like, but if you're smart and you take the right precautions, like charging your lipo before you go to a war, discharging it when you go back. I store mine in a fireproof bag that you can buy off Amazon for like $10, and I carry it in an old ammo can. That's about it, guys. But, you know, lipos are just, it's about the process. So long as you take care of a lipo the right way, there's no problem. You know, and, oh, what happens if they get punctured? Like, literally, I've seen that happen. Because he drove a screwdriver into it on purpose. But other than that, the problem with over-discharging. One, over-discharging is not inherently dangerous. The problem is over-discharging will make it so it'll put damage to your lipo where it won't hold the same charge again. I don't know. It's I'm trying to think of the best way to describe it. I'm not sure of a really good analogy, but all it does is just make it so your battery won't hold as much of a charge the next time. That's why. Well, I would highly recommend a voltmeter for a lot of people. You know, or at least a low voltage alarm. Just something that tells you. I don't have a voltmeter in my Strife, but I also kind of keep an eye on how much I'm using it. I also use it as a sidearm. But, you know, if you're using it as a primary, just having another lipo to swap to is not a bad idea. But yes, I for people who are not very familiar with a lipo, I 100% a voltmeter or like a low volt discharge at the very least. That's just safe right there. Welcome back, Pete. Pete Fuzzy Pete. Okay, I think I'm probably done sanding this half. Wait. Dude, I saw your FDL. Yeah, it arrived at Jesse's shop while I was there. That was crazy, man. Sorry, I really didn't have much more to say about it than that. But, I mean, could have been worse. Alright, second half. I'm probably going to be wrapping this up within the next like 10 to 15 minutes, guys, because I'm going to go eat, spend some time with my wife. But at least I got a lot of the sanding done on this, so that's nice. After this, after the sanding stage, I am going to be doing like the epoxy putty to like really complete the integration. Can an FDL run on IMRs? No. They will not put out enough for it to run the Arduino unit or to run the brushless motors. Just done. Our homemade blasters that are Springer's hard to make? Not really. The science behind them is pretty simple. The execution is completely different. I tried. I didn't do too well. I was also not really putting too much thought into it. I imagine if I go back, I could probably figure something out. But there's a lot of really cool young guys who make terrific ones. Noah Maxwell, Charlie Coleman. You know, they do terrific Springers. They would be people I'd definitely check them out. Charlie Coleman Industries on Facebook. And Noah, I don't remember his, but he's also got a Facebook business page. And he does terrific ones. He wrecked me with a homemade crossbow at Nomne. Like, wrecked me. It was pretty good. Do you know if Drag's fan mailbox is still open? I don't think he ever closes it. But I don't know. Have you ever used mod kits that you can buy? Yes. I like Nerf, I mean Orange Modworks for certain things. I have Orange Modworks in my Alpha Trooper, my Hammer Shot, and my Strong Arm. Like them all. Scar barrels. I have seen very solid data on scar barrels improving accuracy. I have. I'm definitely looking to get one at some point. I really want to get one for my long shot as well, because with a 16 kilogram spring, it's really powerful and I really enjoy it, but like, those darts go everywhere, man, so I really need something a little bit better, you know. I need to really change the angle of this, so. I think we're gonna...
My friend Aiden printed this for me. How terrific is that? Yeah. It's a swagger. No. If you're doing the blaster parts kit, it's all together. Plus the catch and a hammer shot is built into the shell. It's not really an issue. It's not really an issue. This might work. No, it's not. Trying to figure this out, guys. Give me a sec.
Alright, that's just gonna have to do. Whatever. Still working on the second half of this. I know, in fact, Scott already sent me a link for one. I'm gonna be ordering it. Right now, this is balancing on a Lysol wipe. You want food. My wife says food. I'll be up in a second! She might have heard me. I'm not sure. The Nomne footage, I'll be posting it like after my daughter gets here. It's in my vault for stuff to edit. It was really cool. I got to use some like Noms blasters, and I get it. Holy crap. They were terrific. Bye, Steven. Thanks for dropping by, dude. You know a good place to find replacement Alpha Trooper springs. Not Elite Alpha Trooper, the original. They should run off the same spring as a Recon. The plunger to... Yeah, it should just be a Recon spring. You can find Recons anywhere. Do you have a GoPro you recommend? I'm actually in the market for one. That's my big purchase for this year before the next Nerf season starts, is to get myself a new GoPro, because looking at people like Dart Dragon or... Naptown Nerf or some of the other guys who did one. Yeah, Session is great. I really want one. I realized that my old GoPro is a little bit, you know, behind the times. The one advantage my GoPro had for N-War was I managed to buy 5 batteries and just, they're external batteries, so I just swap them out. So what that means is, like, I recorded a ridiculous amount of N-War footage, guys. Like, altogether, I've got like 30 hours of N-War footage. So, yes, knockoffs are terrific. In fact, there's some excellent ones out there that I'm going to be getting. I likely will not be buying a new GoPro. I will likely be getting a different brand. They're terrific, but honestly, I don't see GoPro lasting much more than about 5 more years. Just because of how good the competition's got. Like, there are much cheaper options that are equally as effective as the top-of-the-line GoPros right now. I went to college for film, so I read a lot into cameras, and, like, truthfully, there's a lot of off-brand that provide just as good of a product as GoPro at, like, way less of a price. Drone's better than GoPro. Yeah, but you can't nerf and fly a drone. You can't. So, if you're doing your own stuff, you want your own footage, and you want to actually play, then I highly recommend getting a GoPro. It's definitely the way to go. Once I got mine, like, I love watching all my footage. It's exciting. Like, after a nerf war, I like to take a shower, come home, eat some food, and just watch my footage. You know. And you can download Movie Maker if you have a Windows computer. You can download Movie Maker for free and edit your own videos, which is terrific, guys. You know how I know? Because I'm still using Movie Maker. I'm actually looking into some new software, so that's going to be exciting. Yeah, I can't wait to get a new camera. It's up there. So hopefully my gameplay footage coming back after this leave that I'm on for the baby will hopefully be a lot clearer footage than the stuff you've seen so far. Because I like my gameplay footage, I like the style that I've finally developed. It's taken me months and a couple of different tries to find out, like, what style I wanted to do. And I finally found one I liked. So I'm excited about that, and I'm hoping that if I can get, like, a good, solid camera in. Any wars coming up? Yeah, there was one this Saturday. The SCNC is about to start going to, like, 2 wars in September. I don't see the Nerf creating an automatic pistol. The SMG size, I mean, the Hera, the Strife, I mean, I don't know, they could, it would be a little bit, it's not really in their MO, modus operandi, their usual patterns. What was the best thing you found at a thrift store as far as Nerf? Mine was a Blue Strife and an N-Strike Alpha Trooper. Those are good. I've thrifted, like, 4 Ravens so far. I sell them all off. I actually thrifted one this week. It's not in terrific shape, so I'm giving it to my friend Ray and his son, and we're going to be doing a Straven, I hope. So, that Clark, that's gold. I've never found anything like that. I've found a couple of good old Nerf blasters, a couple of Stripes, a couple of Alpha Troopers, a couple of Ravens, you know, some XBZs, some Titans and stuff. But yeah, I haven't had any luck like that. Yeah. Sanding. Steven, I don't have any experience with him, so I really don't have anything I can really offer there. Sorry, man. Only things I've really got experience with are stripes and, I mean, well, stripes, are lipos and, I used some 14-500 IMRs briefly, and they weren't terrible. I used them in my Strife because I was like, oh, I can just throw these in here real quick, you know, not a big deal. There's actually a lot of Nerf arenas. One just recently started up in Chattanooga, Tennessee. We were going to go, but unfortunately, it's like, it's really small. Like, my Strife, not even the FDL, would have no problem clearing the entire range, like, from one end to the other. So,
Well, all right, Steven, how many people are we talking about? 5 friends, 10 friends, 1 friend? You can have a Nerf war with 1 friend. I do it all the time. By friend, I mean my 4-year-old son, and he's really crappy at running. 10 is a perfect number. There's a lot of really cool game types for 10 people. One of my favorite ones is a game we call King Me. I learned this one at SANC, that's Southern Alabama Nerf Club, with Aurelio. And it basically is like, he got this girly little tiara, right? And it's basically like a team free-for-all, except there's one tiara. And you have to, if you're wearing the tiara and you get shot, the person who shot you has to run over and get the tiara. While they're running, they could get shot and someone else can steal it. And so it's really fun, you know, it's just like, it keeps changing. It's like free-for-all, capture the flag almost, and then whoever has the tiara at the end of the game type wins. That was a lot of fun for 5 to 10 people. So it was like King of the Hill, whatever. That's a good one. Do you have a favorite nerfer from another channel? Well, I am certainly particular to my buddy Dart Dragon, who is my squad mate in the SCNC and Tag Squad. But I think one of my favorite Nerf YouTubers is Aldos. His videos are terrific, and they've really impacted how I do my videos and the commentary style. He runs a parkour gym, or he is part of one, but Aldos does terrific videos. A-L-D-O-S-S. Fantastic videos, guys. Like, I watch all of his. They're definitely my favorites. This is a weird question, but for Nerf events where you have to fly, how or do you get a gun on a plane? No, almost got it. Or do you just drive? It's always fascinating. So, that's where it gets tricky. If you're flying with Nerf blasters, you want to put them in your checked luggage. If you have a flywheel that uses a LiPo, you discharge the LiPo to a storage level, and then you carry it in your carry-on, and you will be asked to check it like with your laptop or tablet at the security checkpoint. But other than that, yes, you can fly with them. Okay, I'm not a very good person to ask about this, Steven. The squad I'm in started as a joke. It was a whole bunch of us tryhards, people who put on like lots of gear and lots of blasters and stuff, and we started this thing called Tac Squad Elite, mostly as a joke. And yet here we are a year later. Yes, I know Coop, or Frank, whatever. Here we are a year later, we still run as a squad, we went to NWAR together as a squad, we have our own like little Facebook chat, and we keep up, but really it's a bunch of good friends, and you know, we carry extra magazines on our back for each other, and we like to run together, but we also fight each other a lot at Nerf Wars. Like, most of the time, I'm not actually on a team with my squad, they intentionally break us up on purpose, which is actually probably a smart idea, but I don't know. Squads are a weird thing to try to do. Have you had any problems with being tactical ever? Yes. July of last year. Not this past July, but the one before that. I tried to wear all black, and now I'm running an NC Star vest, or tactical rig. But before that, I was wearing this like really cool-looking SWAT vest. The problem is, it was literally a vest, not a rig, so it was very hot, and I overheated, and I threw up. That was a problem with being tactical. Also, my first SCNC war, I think they probably thought I was a jerk, because I walked in all this tactical gear, and, I mean, yeah. But the SCNC is probably, like, the most welcoming bunch of dudes I've ever met. They're definitely my best friends. My squad is definitely my best friends. Nope, no problems with the police yet. You know, but the SCNC has very specific rules about the color of your blasters. Doo-doo-doo-doo. What do you do if you're stuck in an elevator with 3 Secret Service officers? I don't know. Never been there. Wouldn't have any idea what I would do. Nor do I understand why that would even be a problem. If I'm in an elevator with Secret Service, as long as I'm not, like, threatening anybody, it should be fine. If you want to be tactical, don't overthink your gear. That's fair. I mean, I put a lot of thought into mine, but I also do a lot of practice in my house. It's kind of crazy. Hang on, got another message. Making sure it's not my wife. Oh God, why are there so many messages? Who are all of you people?
I'm not live on Facebook. I'm live on YouTube. Yeah, I've got a whole bunch of messages. I'll get back to those. Hey, Radian. Radian. I think that's how you say it. He's, actually, we're talking about squads right now, Ray. Ray is in Tac Squad, and he was, you know it to be true. Wait, isn't that a line from Soul Calibur? Search your feelings, you know it to be true. I feel like that's Soul Calibur. Anyway, Ray's in my squad, Tac Squad, with me. We all ran to N-War together, and he made us all really proud. He was a moderator for HBZ N-War 2017, which was a really big deal for us, guys, because Ray gave up the chance to play HBZ N-War with his squad to do it. We didn't run with Ray a single mission. The one mission he did get to play as a human, we were all exhausted. So Ray put in a bigger sacrifice than anybody else I know at N-War, because he was in the van, he heard us all talk and get excited, he rode back with us, hearing us talk about our favorite things, all this YouTube footage that's been posted, and he gave that up to be a moderator. And so he is kind of like my HBZ hero for doing that, because I didn't. I wouldn't. But Ray has always been like a really cool dude and has always looked out for the club. He's one of our best tacticians in coming up with game types, so I'm always happy to have him around, because like you can bounce ideas off game types, and Ray is like awesome with that. Also, he makes really cool Lego mechs, which I'm suck at. I suck so bad at making Legos, guys. How do you price commissions? I do them for my friend, and I feel like I don't want to charge them a lot, but yeah. Yeah. What's up, nerd? There's another one of my squad mates. FDL. Yeah. So, yeah, I haven't been reading Facebook chat because I'm on this. Do you do commissions? Not really. I mean, I'm doing one right now, but it's a blaster trade with a friend of mine. You know, he's making me a blaster, I'm making him a blaster, but I don't know. I do these for fun. The problem is, and for doing commissions, I've never done commissions for Nerf, like monetary ones, but I used to do a lot of freelance video editing for commission, and it's a slippery slope when you try to start valuing your time, because like, let's just say you're talking $8 an hour. I'm probably going to be putting in 2 hours in sanding. Do I charge the guy $16 for sanding? I don't know. It's a slippery slope, and it's a quick way to get, you know, kind of disgruntled. Who's the trade? Randy from End War. I met him through Facebook and about FDLs, and we met up at End War. It's really cool. Which FDL is this? That's Project FDL, Mr. FDL himself. Is it possible to make a Nerf grenade, which is a grenade with holes? Yes, Nerf didn't make one, but there's another company that made one. I think it's Busby? I don't know, somebody did. Oh, both FDLs are in here. Terrific. I'm Shandy. I was also supposed to be upstairs. Holy crap. It's 7:18 my time. I was supposed to be up for dinner 48 minutes ago. Well, it's gonna be bad. So, anyway, yeah, I am supposed to be upstairs. I'm supposed to be upstairs, not like 10 minutes ago, not 30 minutes ago, like, whoops. I'm not really late for dinner. My wife is pregnant, so she eats when she's ready to eat. But my wife also knows I've had like a hell of a week at work, and she's letting me do this because it makes me happy. And literally, it's just costing me sandpaper. Can't get much better than that. So, anyway, Jackie and Jesse, what's going on? Oh yeah, it's going to be so great seeing everybody in September. Well, no, I won't be at the Nerf War in September. Sadly, I will be there in October. That is what it is. Anyway, so, I'm gonna wrap this up. I'm already late, so, we're just gonna, any other favorite hobbies? I like to draw. That's a hobby.
And my other hobbies I don't really talk about in here. I like body modification. I'm just going to leave it at that. But it kind of squicks or grosses some people out. So, awesome. I am looking forward to seeing you in Birmingham tomorrow. You got to stop by and say hi. Yeah. So, yeah. Later, guys. And so, I'm going to be wrapping this up in less than 10 minutes. If you have any last-minute questions, now is the time to ask. Oh, yep. There's my wife. I know, Emma. I know I said I was going to be up at 6:30, and it's 7:20. I'm going to be an hour late. I was out partying with the boys, getting wild, you know, strippers, whatever. I'm kidding. I've been down here in the workshop the whole time. Look at that, guys. Have you ever used a Dart Tag Snapfire 8? I have, and I like it. Whatever, I had chicken. Have a good night. Later, Brent. Work that. Yeah. You know, look. I was really, like, trying to set up my camera so this doesn't look bad. It doesn't work. So, yes, I'm literally just sitting here sanding a blaster. I do understand how this looks. I do. I get it. So, yes, guys. No Love Lost 510 is my wife who ate all the chicken. But that's okay. Is that a pistol?
Is this a pistol?
Sanding. Oh, my God. Radiant. Leave that one alone, Ray. I am sending my blaster. My wife has joined me at a Nerf war. It was a lot of fun. It was the Tennessee's largest Nerf war. She hasn't Nerfed with me at the SCNC yet, but that's going to change eventually. But yeah, she is like 9 months pregnant, so yeah, she's not Nerfing at the moment. But she will. She wants to. And, you know, I'm going to be building her a blaster. It's going to be kind of fun. Not sure what I'm going to do with it yet. She is busy making more nerfers. Yeah, it's great. Did you actually eat all the chicken? You are building me a baby. What do you think is the best thing you could do with a long shot front gun? Pick it up, cock your arm back, and throw it. That's about it. Yeah. I've seen someone do like a good pump grip system using the long shot. And you know, it's not bad. I think you could do that with it, I guess. Well, Ray, I try to keep it, I mean, I don't know, it's not super, I wouldn't say mature, you know, it does get PG-13 at times. It's gotten a lot better since I've stopped drinking excessively while trying to film YouTube videos, because at the beginning of my channel, guys, I would do all my videos, In one go, like start to finish, the whole video one take, because I wasn't editing. And so I'd mess up, I'd drink a little bit, and I'd keep going. And eventually, usually the ones that made it to YouTube was where I was so, I drank enough where I was like, whatever. Yeah, I've had one beer. One. And it's empty. There's another beer down here, but it's been in my garage for about 3 months, 4 months, unrefrigerated. I'm not gonna chance it. Oh god, I'm tangled. So yeah, here we are. Getting pretty well sanded. Yeah. So I'm gonna wrap up the sanding for this tomorrow. Cause I'm done sanding now. My arm hurts. I already sanded this whole side. Uh, I run 16, 18 mags, and I like it. I've only seen one person, one, ever truly make a good, like, drum-based loadout, and that's Daniel, Dart Dragon, on YouTube. Only person I've ever seen actually run a good loadout with mags. Everyone else looks completely awkward doing it. When is the live wet sanding? Not doing it, Ray. My wife would kill me if I got this shit in the house. That's why I have a workshop. And I can blow it out with a leaf blower. So that's nice. Project FDL is a channel, Jesse Kevorkian. Yes, that's Project FDL. I never will say his name right. I tried it once. He laughed. That's it. That's where I'm stopping trying that. But other than that, I've made quite the mess in my workshop. But again, because it's a garage, and there's the garage door, means I can literally just take a leaf blower and blow all of this out. It's the best. I don't even have to sweep anymore. I'm a lazy person. Kovarovics, I know. I knew that. I say, of course. Duh. But, yeah. So, I've got 4 minutes. Can we just do a dance party for 4 minutes? Can you get an auto sander? Yes, you can. And in fact, the early part of this video, I was using a mouse sander to remove the decals and logos and all this other stuff from the blaster, but nothing will get you quite the finish like hand sanding with like some good high grain paper. So I hand sand all my blasters. I actually have a disco ball upstairs. I do. Emma, don't, yeah, there's a disco ball in that big box that I told you I was gonna put in the attic tonight. I didn't. But I put the car seat together, so, yeah. So anyway, guys, I'm going to wrap this up real quick because I'm coming up on 2 hours. Holy crap. Projects I'm working on. I picked this up at a thrift store. We're going to cut it up. We're going to make it a Straven because there's a guy, really cool dude, crazy hatcher man, who wants a Straven. I'm going to box this stuff up. I was supposed to mail it out today. I didn't. So, yeah, this video has been running for 1 hour, 56 minutes. Yes. I'm going to be sending these to Aiden. He gets 2 of these packs of magazines and darts. And Noah, for this, on the SCNC, I ran a group competition for best tactical role video. And so we had a lot of people, like, post comments of their videos of them doing a tactical role. And, yeah, Noah got 2nd place. I'm going to be mailing his. I told you I said it today. I was hoping you weren't here. I'm going to mail it out tomorrow. Promise. It's been a crazy day. But yeah, Aiden did a really cool one. I didn't really have a grading system. I just kind of like, I thought it was really cool because at first I laughed at him. I did. Because I thought he dropped his mag. Because he did. He did this little roll and like his mag fell out. But then he like picked up another one and loaded it. I thought it was really cool and surprising. So yeah, Noah had the most like tactically sound roll and like a perfect firing thing. But style points, I had to give it to the underdog. So other than that, I really want to take this apart. Super Soaker, I'm going to put a strife in it. I'm kidding, guys. I'm going to calm down. I'm not Rob. Okay, I'm not. I'm going to chill out a little bit. I'm going to put a strife in this. It's really cool. Other than that, there's some more internal pieces for that. I picked up this thing at a thrift store. Surprising. I like it. Other than that, there's the demolisher I'm going to be working on. I got a couple of strifes. I hope this doesn't replay the chat. It won't. We learned that when we did the live stream going to, and then at FoamCon and on the way back, that these comments will not show up. They won't. Though that being said, comments made after this video gets published will be there. But other than that, yeah, just all sorts of stuff. Working on some cosplay stuff, making a big helmet. So yeah. Anyways, guys, it is 19:29 my time. This video has been going on for 1 hour, 58 minutes, 31 seconds. I am now 1 hour late for dinner. It's really bad. I've been very bad. But there's a bunch of mag strikes. Woo! So, anyways, guys, thank you guys for joining me as I sand, because sanding by yourself is lame. I hope to be doing more of these. These are actually really easy for me to do, and I can just kind of like spontaneously do them. I've been kind of stuck trying to figure out how I'm going to generate content as we're sitting here waiting for the baby to be born. So doing this has been a lot of fun. I will probably be doing another one later in the week. Hopefully by then I'll be sanding the puttied blaster. Oh, it's right there, right?
Duh. Only half. The other half's going to be red because it's a Centurion. So, anyway, guys, thank you very much for tuning in and keeping me company as I sand this blaster for Randy and make it. I'm really excited. I'm really going to be excited about reviewing his video when it finally gets here, or his blaster. Really stoked about that. Other than that, if you guys do have any questions, definitely hit me up on Facebook at TK1138Nerf. And, you know, we can talk about blasters, your blasters, my blasters, game types, loadouts, whatever. I'm pretty flexible about just wanting to talk about Nerf. I like Nerf. So, anyway, guys, I know I've said goodbye three times, so this is going to be the last one because I just hit 2 hours. So, this has been TK1138. Nerf well, my friends.